Of course, it had to be a remote private island in the middle of the ocean. An eccentric millionaire, his trophy wife, troublemaking ex-con brother.
And who knows who else there is. All of them stuck inside an old castle turned into a modern villa, with a dead body washed up on the beach. Not the kind of case I'd expect to get with a new rookie partner, but hey, we're in this together now. The report says it's a suicide. We should be able to wrap this one up quickly and get back to the mainland by morning. All right, let's go. Inspector, before we head inside, we should go through the case files together. Just to make sure we didn't miss something. We left a bag with the files in the plane. I'll see if I can announce our arrival. The buzzer is broken. I couldn't get a hold of anyone. How about those files now? Did you get the files? All right, I think we covered everything. Let's see if we can fix that buzzer.
Greetings, inspectors. I'm Henry Bradford, and this is my lawyer, Mr. Alexei Tarkov. Welcome to my island.
Please call me Alexei. We spoke over the intercom, Inspector.
We hope you'll finish your investigation quickly, so we can put this tragedy behind us, and hopefully avoid any unnecessary publicity. Through the doors and into the backyard. We found poor Mark on the beach below the cliff.
If you spot anything worthwhile, take a photo of it. Here's an instant camera. Check the broken fence. I'll look around the yard. It's too dark here. We need some light to see better. Try and find something we can use. A flashlight will do for now. Time to get our hands dirty. Let's start with the body. Let's discuss the case once we know more. Look what I found. A bloody earring stuck in the fence. I doubt Mark wore it. Let's discuss the case once we know more. This was not an accident, after all. We have a murder on our hands. And the time of death, too. Let's go and talk to the residents. We have to take everybody's statement and check their alibis. The killer might be among them. Hello, Mr. Tarkov. My partner and I have suspicions about this case. It might not have been an accident, after all. Do you mind if we ask you a couple of questions about Mark?
Horrible. Well, surely that can't be. Well, but of course, please, the inspectors, ask away. Yesterday, early in the morning? He came in for tea? After that, I didn't see him for the rest of the day. The next thing I knew was when Edward rushed in, yelling that poor Mark was dead. I met him when he came to work here. He had a professional background in security, perfect for this job. He was a good man. Over time, he became like a member of the family. I did some chores around the house, I fed the snakes, and did some important legal accounting for the company. I finished sometime after 9 o'clock.
One more thing. Is there anyone who can confirm your alibi?
When I finished the accounting work, I gave the papers to Richard and went to bed early.
That's all, Mr. Tarkov. Thank you for your cooperation.
Well, thank you, Inspectors. If you need anything else, I'm at your full disposal.
Inspectors!
Richard Jones, I presume. Can I talk to you about the death of Mr. Mark Spector? We suspect his death was not an accident.
It wasn't? Oh, no. Please, I'm at your full disposal. Anything I can do to help, just say the word. I got him this job. He was a decent guy. We met in Wales while I was on a business trip. I went to a bar, got into some trouble, and he helped me out. If he hadn't been there, I wouldn't have this pretty face anymore. I'll miss him. And now you say his death might not be an accident. I just can't believe it. Yesterday, during lunch, we had a Yorkshire pudding. Alexi makes the best one. After a bit of small talk about our hobbies, we went our separate ways. I was right here, stargazing with the telescope. I was hoping to catch a comet passing by. They say the sky is the clearest just before a storm, but sadly, no luck.
Who can we confirm your alibi with?
I spoke with Henry when he finished working in his study. A bit later, Alexa came and gave me some company legal papers.
That will be all, Mr. Jones. Thank you. You were very helpful.
If you need anything, Inspectors, just ask away. I want my friend's death resolved.
Let's go talk to Henry.
Inspectors, how's the investigation going?
Unfortunately, Mr. Bradford, it appears your employee was murdered.
I saw him yesterday morning. I went to tell him to finish the repairs on the island model in the foyer. Patricia damaged it during the recent fight we had. He never got to fixing it, though. I was watching a rugby game with my brother and his fiancée Grace in the guest wing. It's one of those rare brotherly traditions we still keep. He worked here as a guard. Besides that, we didn't really have any special connection. My wife always said he was a good guy, though.
And what of your wife, Mr. Bradford? Where is she?
My wife? Well, to be honest, she and I had a fight. She left for the mainland 2 days ago. I'm sure she'll be back in a few days. She just needs to cool off. I don't know how to tell her about Mark, though.
One more thing. Did you see Richard last night?
Yes. When I was passing the lobby, he appeared to be stargazing and filming the sky for one of his many astronomy collections.
That is all. You were of great help.
I hope you get to the bottom of this quickly. I had to pull some strings with the commissioner so this doesn't get into the press. Please keep that in mind.
Good evening. I'm afraid we have to interrupt you to ask a few questions about Mark Spector's death.
I can't believe he's gone. Poor Mark. He deserved better.
When I found him, I supposed it was an accident. With the questions you inspectors are asking, I'm starting to have doubts about that. I'm not sure. Yesterday around noon? Something like that.
I saw him when he went to take the Broken Island model in the foyer. That was the last I saw of him.
We were all right. He wasn't my best friend or anything, but he was a good, decent worker.
He was such a happy character. You'd never see him frown or be mad about anything. He was always positive, making his little figurines and smartening this place up. I joined Edward, and we watched his favourite team play. Henry was unavailable, as usual.
I wanted to watch the game with Henry, but he only came in after the first half. I was surprised he even bothered to show up.
You said Henry was unavailable? What was he doing?
Well, he and Patricia argued quite vocally last night. That's why she left in the morning. Why else would she leave so suddenly?
They argued... well, often in the last couple of weeks, didn't they? She didn't seem happy lately.
That will be all for now. If we need anything else, we'll let you know. We should probably confirm everyone's alibi next. We need to investigate inconsistency in Patricia's alibi.
Thank you.
We need to investigate inconsistency in Patricia's alibi.
Thank you.
This is it, partner. She was there on the night of the murder. Let's talk to Henry about his wife. I'll get the lights. This is bad. Another murder, and we're nowhere near solving the first one. Let's search the crime scene. See if we can find some clues. Look, partner, a secret panel. Maybe it's connected with what happened to Henry. I'll call for backup from the lobby. Come get me if you find something important. The storm's too fierce. Backup won't get here until it passes. We'll have to do what we can till they arrive. All right. What do we know so far? We already concluded that Patricia was a witness to Mark Spector's murder. But now we know more. The ransom note suggests she was kidnapped, most likely after the murder. These two crimes are almost certainly connected. If we can find Patricia, there's a chance we'll find the murderer as well. He couldn't have left the island in this weather. Start from Henry and Patricia's room and look for clues while I secure the new crime scene. Strange. Their bedroom's just through the guest wing. Thank you. The evidence you found suggests that Edward was probably the last person who saw Henry before he was killed. Right now, he's our prime suspect. We should interrogate him immediately. Find him. I'll join you when I finish securing the crime scene. We don't want to miss anything here. Take this. I found it under the couch. It might be useful.
Thank you. Hey, calm down. It's not safe to stay in this cabin. The helicopter might come.
I want out of here, right now.
Honey, calm down. It's not safe to fly in this weather. The helicopter might crash.
It's not safe here. I want to get off this island and never come back.
As soon as the storm dies down, we'll leave, I promise. In the meantime, I'll prepare the helicopter.
Don't go now. I don't want to be alone.
Please, try to rest a bit. You'll feel better. I'll be back in no time. Inspector, we weren't expecting you. Please do come in. You'll have to excuse me. Grace is quite upset by all this. I have to go upstairs and try to calm her down.